Hey, this is Kelly from Car Data Video here to show you the new Ford Escape Hybrid for 2008. This is the upgraded version of the hybrid. They've done some restyling on it, which is nice. They've refined the suspension. They've done some other things to really make it a more enjoyable vehicle than it has been in the past. This is the front-wheel drive version. You can get front and all-wheel drive. As I mentioned, it's a hybrid, and so it has some unique features about it. They've added considerably to the safety aspects of the vehicle this year. It has four-wheel ABS disc brakes, anti-lock disc brakes. It has front, side, and side curtain airbags, which is very helpful. It has tire pressure monitoring system. It has a latch system. It comes with privacy glass, roof rails, fog lamps, 16-inch aluminum wheels, and just a variety of things that make the vehicle quite a bit more enjoyable than it has been in the past. It seems more refined than previous models. If you go inside the Escape Hybrid, you can see it's a pretty nice place to spend time. It's not a luxurious vehicle, but it does have some very nice features to it. You'll notice that bucket seats come standard with this vehicle, as well as a nice attractive gauge cluster. Tells you what's going on very nicely. Also comes with tilt and cruise. Power windows and power locks are standard. You'll also notice that the driver's seat is a power, six-way power seat. Again, that's standard equipment in this vehicle. And you'll also notice that there's a center armrest, cup holders, storage bin, and a floor shifter. It's also standard on this machine. Interestingly, because it's a hybrid, it has a lot of electricity, so there's a 110-volt AC power plug, so you can plug in any household type of appliance, maybe not a toaster, but it will really power your equipment on the go. The rear seat also is spacious. Again, this is an SUV, and there's lots of room in the vehicle. Rear seat space is folded, or is split rather, 60-40 fold. Lots of leg room, and the seating position is quite good. The center console goes back to the rear seat position, so you've got a couple cup holders there, and the interior you'll find is quite configurable. There's a good headroom, there's a good elbow room, and right behind those seats you'll see there's a good cargo area also to put your valuables and your belongings. This is a hybrid, and so one of the challenges that all auto manufacturers have is where do you put things, how do you package your equipment efficiently. And so you want to keep the cargo area as open as you possibly can and have this vehicle be like other non-hybrid vehicles. Where do you put the batteries? So what Ford has cleverly done is they've designed a battery pack that's flat and fits under the cargo area in the back of the vehicle. So it's basically unobtrusive and it does not cut into your cargo space. Also, you'll notice that there is a cargo cover, actually like a big roller blind, but basically you put your whatever you're carrying in the back, your valuables, whatever, underneath this cargo cover, so they're out of sight of anybody that happens to be passing by. Again, it's a very configurable vehicle. Another neat feature about the Escape is with the press of a button you can either have the whole lift gate or just the glass within the lift gate open. And where this is useful is if you're carrying something really long, you can actually have it sticking out the back of the glass without having to have the whole door open. Very nice feature you don't often see in this class of vehicle. One of the reasons people buy SUVs is because they have very configurable interior. So what do you do with the second row of seats? You need to get them out of the way in order to get maximum cargo area. How the Escape handles this is you pull up this tab on the second row of seat bottoms and it folds forward out of the way. You take the headrest out of the second row seat backs and you merely fold it forward. And what you've got then is this wonderfully flat cargo area that goes from the back of the vehicle all the way to the front. We mentioned that 60-40 split seats, so you can have the 60 side down, the 40 side down, or if you want, you can have both of them down at the same time for a large cargo area. And that roller blind mechanism we talked about, the cargo cover, also is removable, again, so you've got unobstructed cargo volume. It's very nice. The interior of this Escape Hybrid is an upgraded one. In addition to that, it has what's called a hybrid premium package. So that includes the stone leather trim. That's the color of it. It has heated mirrors and a leather-wrapped steering wheel and some bright work on it and some nice features. In addition to that, it has a navigation system, and when you turn the vehicle on, it starts up and asks for approval. Then it gives you maps, it gives you audio information, and also gives you hybrid drive information also. After driving the Escape Hybrid for a couple of days, I ended up liking it quite a lot. It actually has better power than the V6, and it has better fuel economy than most small cars with four-cylinder engines, and it doesn't have any emissions at all. It's a nice small SUV, good seating position, easy to get in and out of. It parks very easily, it's responsive, it's quiet, it's really a nice vehicle to drive. I think Ford has a starting price of just over $25,000, but you can get, according to Ford's website, a $3,000 tax credit for certain buyers. That's not a deduction, that's a credit, which makes it a pretty good value proposition. So Ford may have a winner this time. This is Kelly from Car Data Video.